Darth Vader. This makes no sense. Think about it! Think about it, goddammit!
I'm just from Jesus.
I fucking Zoidberg.
Exactly.
I hope those help themselves.
I can't do high pitch. I'm too low pitch.
Oh, man.
Alright. Sound's working. We're good.
Sounds working.
We can do something.
Are we streaming?
Yes, we're streaming.
We're streaming.
We're streaming.
Alright. Hello, internets.
Hello. Internets.
We're getting ready to play Outlast. I have never seen this before.
What is this madness?
Wait, hold on. You're not allowed to do it yet. Okay, basically, we have to announce to the presses that tonight...
The presses. Yes, that like the internets?
Yeah, the internet presses, exactly.
What is
just
the internet name?
The internet names? I don't know. What, are we on your account?
We're just on Kraken.
We're just on Kraken.
Well, I'm loaded to both channels.
That's cool.
Okay, basically, what's going on right now
is that
tonight... The Slagathor... Over here. Come over to the camera, dude. Come over into the camera. The camera's right there.
Just get real nice and close up.
That's right.
I forgot that I was recording.
I don't know. Can you see it?
I'm on the internet myself.
Can you see this guy?
Yeah.
Okay, this guy right here does not drink. He is not a drinker in the slightest. So
I've only had 4 drinks in 26 years.
So basically, we convinced him to drink with us tonight.
Which is...
And we are right now drinking. We are advertising this right now. And this is Taka Vodka, flavored like whipped cream. And we're drinking with cranberry juice, which tastes like a red velvet cake.
Pinnacle's better.
So,
Pinnacle is
so
better.
So now I have one full hand.
So now what's going on is he is going to drink right now, and you enjoy. Watch him do it. Out of a goblet.
Out of a goblet.
Hold on. Cheers.
Only. That's the only acceptable way to do it.
Cheers, everybody.
We're also sponsoring Herpes Day.
Herpes Day here. National Herpes Day.
As of now.
September 25th.
September 25th is National Herpes Day. As of right now.
Our special guest, Herpes.
Where's Herpes?
In my hands. I'm holding Herpes.
Just make sure the controller works.
We have a special shout out and advertisement to Amaya's.
Oh, yes, to Amaya's Ultra Lounge in Riverside.
Which we had just gotten back from and had more drinks from. So
we are already foregone and we're about to do some more with all of you.
Always, sorry.
So, yes. Alright, so here we go.
To Outlast. You want the ceiling light up or?
Nash them up right now. Right. I just want to make sure the camera can see.
See if we can outlast that last.
Insane! Let's just do hard.
I think I just went with normal, but.
I don't know.
Whatever floats your boat.
Outlast contains intense violence, gore, graphic sexual content, and strong language. Please enjoy.
You
are Miles. Okay, hold on. Story time. You are Miles Upshur. Investigative reporter whose ambition is about to earn him an intimate tour of hell on earth.
So he's going to New Orleans.
He's what?
He's going to New Orleans.
He's going to New Orleans, exactly.
New Orleans.
Oh, no, he's going to the DMV, man.
Okay.
Always willing to risk digging into the stories no other journalist would dare to investigate, you will seek out the dark secret at the heart of the Mount Massive Asylum. Stay alive as long as you can. Record everything. You are not a fighter. To navigate the horrors of Mount Massive and expose the truth, your only choices are to run, hide, or die.
I choose die.
I need my glasses. I can't read anything.
I don't know how you read that pretty well.
Exactly. And very, very,
gusto.
Gusto.
And he died right afterwards.
Wait,
that was so depressing. We're talking about Avengers 2.
Damn it! Spoilers!
He doesn't know what we're talking about. Alright, so no one insults my glasses. I look like a pen with a trumpet.
Except he's smashed during most movies we gotta see.
Yeah, Consult at Murkoff Psychiatric Systems facilities at Mount Massive. All sorts of NDAs, and I'm very much breaking through now, but seriously, fuck those guys. Terrible things are happening there. Don't understand it. Don't believe half the things I saw. Doctors talking about dream therapy going on too deep, finding something that has been waiting for them in the mountain. People are being hurt, and Murkoff is making money. It needs to be exposed.
Expose it!
Expose the shit out of it!
It's forward! It's Bill Cipher.
Where's the fruit?
There's all the buttons.
Okay, so what do I got? Some batteries,
batteries.
And a video camera.
Yo.
Everything you need. Shit. That's an old ass camera, man.
So, you're basically going through all this horror stuff while recording.
Yep.
Huh. So, it must be. Oh, shit.
Light vision.
It must be really awkward when it comes down to, going through these horrible situations and.
Objectives are updating your report notebook and the back space containing your notebooks left and documents to the right. So notes, notebooks. Whistleblower, that's the note I just read, and then that is basically just a hub.
Yep. Time to go explore.
Nope, first I gotta get my liquid courage.
You're looking
exactly.
My very
be Jorah the Explorer.
I'm going to be Jorah the Explorer who is permanently in the friend zone!
Because it's a Facebook post that says Jorah freaking Doris.
Wait, can I jump?
Oh, you can jump. Oh my god, that's a new thing for all of us. Except maybe Bioshock.
Oh, Bioshock's not a horror game.
Semi-horror.
There's parts where it's kind of creepy.
I don't know.
Especially the one where you're just supposed to be a regular guy.
To open a door, press X to open the door, slowly hold down X. I started feeling sick just looking at this place. Mount Massive Asylum shut down amid scandal and government secrecy in 1971, reopened by Murkoff Psychiatric Systems in 2009 under the guise of a charitable organization. Cell phone reception cut off abruptly a mile out, more like a jammer than lost signal. The Murkoff Corporation's long track record of disguising profit as charity, but never on American soil. Whatever they thought they can get out of this place has been too big. It might finally be the story that breaks those bastards.
Those bastards.
Break those bastards.
Break them!
Okay, so I have to put them down. Alright. Cardio! Just pop it. a really is this asylum for midgets, or he's really fucking tall?
It's a really old asylum.
Well, you know, they were pretty short back then.
Yeah, that's true. Like, I heard that, like, in general, the average height's been increasing over the generations. Like, Napoleon.
Hooray for evolution.
Napoleon was not short!
He was short compared to our time.
No!
He was the same size as
short to me, damn it!
No, dude, metric system did not make it over, so the measurements were different.
Very well, then, I accept it. I thought it was more of a...
That's historical fact has to do with, basically... See, now he's too fucking short to fit. No, but according to the records, that he was normal, actually, even if a little bigger than normal height, but because we measured it in meters versus feet, he was considered short because of the measurement difference.
And that's your history lesson for this evening.
That is your history lesson, exactly! Alright, so...
What do you know?
I was about to say that. I was like, we need rainbows!
We need rainbow shit!
Quick, get rainbow dash.
Rainbow dash.
Alright, I don't know, I'm looking at stuff, and there's trees, and there's a fountain that looks like there's algae growing in it. And
it's got
You know, home preservation-wise, it looks alright.
Yeah, I think we need to shock it, because vector control's a dick.
I mean, the shrubs are pretty nice.
The shrubs are pretty nice.
They're not touching anything.
They're not growing in the house of the fence line.
Did you guys press pass when you left?
If I'm trying to break into the place, I'm pretty sure press pass wouldn't help anyways.
Hold on, crazy guy. I'm with the press.
Okay. Then why are you breaking in? Come in the front door.
That's what I was saying.
It's like if you have a press pass, come break in.
We're just like fuck the press.
There's a window. No window. Right? Oh, this one.
There you go.
All right.
Window.
I was having an animal house flashback just now.
Oh, yeah.
Where I'm just like, hello, mate!
Okay,
gotcha.
But the battery doesn't affect your recording ability.
which is random.
Oh, look, it's teamwork.
Teamwork! Team broken.
It says Patrick!
Yes!
Yeah!
I am here! I'm in the game! Yes, Patrick.
You did it!
You made it through.
Someone got pissed at it, but.
Oh, that's crap. I wasn't sure if it was brakes or cobwebs.
Oh, I see.
Oh, it's a broken.
It's a team. Exemplified teamwork.
Yeah,
8-2-4. Okay, let's go slowly, because I don't trust. I've played enough survival horrors that I know not to just jam through a door.
He's a master of silent hill.
They forgot to hang up the phone, those bastards.
This bill's gonna be outrageous.
Okay. Okay. Murkoff Psychiatric Systems, Project Wall Rider. Mount Massive, case number 174, patient initials, WPH Billy, consultation date, blah, 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 initial data, I don't care about you. Therapy status, patient claims to have progressed to self-directed lucid dream states. Morphogenic engine activity observed at unprecedented scale, continuing stage 4 hormone schedule. Diagnostics. Spirometry revealed no bronchial accumulation. Hemocrit centrifuge again failed to separate erythrocytes. Highly worrisome. MRI revealed arrhythmic REM and REM cycle. Laughter and REM state. Interview notes.
This is the second page, too.
So it sounds like his rapid eye movement, his REM state, he has freaking random laughter and his non-REM.
Yeah, they're kind of doing something to him.
Okay, Billy asks about the status of his mother's lawsuit against Murkoff in the asylum. This represents a catastrophic breach in security despite Billy's claims that he has discovered the truth in the blood dreams of Dr. Trager. Notes only Trager on company records. One, Richard Trager is an executive of MRD. All orderlies and security personnel must be questioned. Video security improved to include analytical biometrics. Murkoff Psychiatric System, Project Wall Rider, Mount Massive. Colorado?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's in Colorado.
Okay, so he's doing random shit when he's in his non-rapid eye movements, that dream state.
Yep.
But when he's in his REM state, he is perfectly fine.
Something like that. Looking at the blood spot.
Love it to realize.
Oh yeah. So, if any of you have seen the freaking Last of Us video I did, we work in freaking construction, kind of stuff.
Whoa, God.
So, we will comment on that quite a bit.
I think you gotta do that many times. After 5 minutes of just talking about blood drinking.
And you were just patiently waiting for us to leave the room.
Yeah, I was like, shut the fuck up!
I'm just in the damn vent! Because the second a small light happens, you blind yourself.
Didn't they do that in,
Person of Interest?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, season 3, yeah. They didn't think of Person of Interest, and Reese was like, you know what, you're all night vision? Fuck you! Lights are turned off. Oh my god, I can't see!
Yeah,
I think Brandon from episode 1. Holy shit! No, fuck you!
The Master of Survival Horror, right here.
I was in the middle of talking about it.
Disrespect. Whatever part is left of them.
I have no clue, dude.
God, everyone looks down. cross eyed.
Well, not cross.
How did anybody take a picture like that?
Holy shit.
I'm just like.
I understand what they do. I have no clue. Wasted out in the West, why people never smile back in those days.
Little fake. Merciful God, you have sent me an apostle. Guard your life, son. You have a calling.
We have a calling!
I have a calling!
Achievement, your calling. Is it collect? Is it collect?
Can you hear me now?
Good.
Oh, more blood.
Why don't I just get out the same way I got in through that fucking window?
Because you know.
Well, because you're sort of crazy hanging in there, and they will throw you back down. Yes, that's all he does.
I mean, seriously, like, it's not that hard to get up there.
It's his whole job, though, to throw you back down. Because what you do, you get all the chairs, all the desks together. Basically, you know, stack them up, stack them up.
I was actually going to rip up this guy's intestines and use that as a rope, but okay.
That'd be intense, slippery, though. Nice to tell.
Well, then I take my shirt off and use that to get the friction.
He's gonna use a shirt to get the friction. And does the intestine actually have enough strength to be able to hold it? That's the thing, yeah. What's the weight capacity on an intestine?
I don't know. I don't rip people open enough to know this kind of stuff.
He doesn't do it enough yet.
He's working up to it.
You're the game theorist.
Game theory. It's a game theory.
Hey, it's just a theory. Game.
Oh, you picked up a battery in that shit.
Ew. Dude, I was dealing with enough shitty toilets today. I almost brought them up like, dude, this is the toilet of the day. I'm trying to restart that, but no one's doing it. That's a
battery, though. But I mean, this is the same time, of course.
And I think it's funny that the only batteries I find in this joint are the exact ones that fit my camera. Like, there's no AAAs, there's no 9 volts, there's no C's or D's, it's all AA's.
This is a perfect world where AA's fit everything.
That would be a perfect world.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always look for AA stuff, I'm like, damn it, it's AAA.
I don't know,
I
like,
buy it now.
Damn you, AAA!
Like, I'm sitting there playing.
Damn
like,
you, button cells!
Like, I'm playing, like, Silent Hill, and every single box of ammunition randomly sitting on a park bench happens to fit my gun.
Oh, well, I mean, that might happen if it was 9mm.
No, I don't know what the caliber was, but...
It's like,
but no, that's the
one you find.
Like, either it's a universal handgun, it's a universal shotgun, or a universal rifle ammo.
If you don't use the 9mm, then fuck you.
Pretty much.
Like, it's not a fight, like, it's a rifle ammo, not a 223 or a 5.4, it's just the rifle ammo.
Yeah.
Like, there's a difference.
It's like, it's not a 308 or 5.56 or a 7.62 by 39 AK round, no.
No, it's just rifle ammo. Oh. Why are we talking about random shit? Okay, so this,
Because it's a horror game, and that's what we do.
I wonder if they have Tetris on this computer.
Probably not. They have Galaga.
They got Galaga.
That man is playing Galaga.
That guy must have, he didn't think anyone noticed.
That's why he died, he was busy playing Galaga.
The guy died?
No, I'm talking about people in the office in this game.
Oh, okay.
Galaga causes death in the office.
God damn it.
I'm gonna start hard pacing.
What did we tell you about Galaga?
Shh. Hold on, real quick, I'm gonna listen.
Oh.
Keep reading. I like how he puts his hand on whatever he's near.
Yeah, I like
Look
that.
Look at that. It's just like.
His hands are really fucked up, man. But I can actually tilt around corners.
He's a journalist. Therefore, his hands are fucked up. Oh, yes, I'm gonna touch this wall.
With all that writing and typing. Okay, what's in the middle of the room on your left?
It's
a guy in a wheelchair, I think. Quick bludgeon to death.
What's up,
picture.
Dude?
I swear it moved.
Oh, look, it's Derpy face.
That guy looks like a
Derpy.
That guy looks like a fucking pedophile.
Give the Derpy one muffins. Okay, so it's a wheelchair man. But he's moving though.
yeah, they're just looking at some blood, you know? They're inside, bodies everywhere, blood, burn marks, heads lined up like bottles behind the bar, a dead Markov scientist hung from the ceiling, their badges say Markov events. Research systems, Markov long time MO, has been profit of the exploitation that is supposed to charity. Fuck the third world and bankroll another billion. Okay. How did Markov think they would make money off of a building full of crazy people? There's some kind of technical cop pinned like a pig on a spit. Tells me get the fuck out, then dies. What would have been a good thing if I hear when I could still leave the way I came? That would have been a good thing. Okay.
They're looking at that blood on the
TV screen. Yeah,
so TV screen like it's art or something.
Yeah, a crowd of broken men watching a dead channel. They look like patients. They survived whatever happened here, but no more.
So they're all basically media.
I feel like this is an improvement to be honest. Instead of watching a man fart, just like, look. Well,
because you're in the end, let the thing you're down there. To be honest, I don't think I'm ever going to do a fucking recording without some kind of alcohol involved.
Yeah. Exactly. It makes everything more fun.
Put the time door closed.
Just maybe I'm thinking red velvet because it's
red.
Red.
It didn't taste it like cranberry juice.
And now it's time for repair.
Future rare claw. I think I have a little bit left of my jelly. Cause you know the one thing you need to do when you leave a bar is go get donuts.
Nothing.
All right.
Idea brought you by.
Brought you by Yum-Yums.
So much advertising. Steal that wheelchair and ride down the stairs.
Yes! Let's do this! Just like
police will come, and I'll show them the evidence.
No, I mean, the place we go to when this all blows over is just go to the Winchester.
To the Winchester.
Grab a giant wait for this all to blow over.
Obviously.
Get in the car, Barbara! Out of my scalp, a couple cracked ribs nearly killed his former giant. Looks like somebody tried to fuck start his head with a cheese grater. He already throws me through a wall, knocks me unconscious. I wake up in some doughy old man with a face like an alcoholic kitty fizzler and a homemade freestyle pickles with his apostle. Not a job I asked for. There are words scrawled in blood everywhere. I am getting an ugly feeling in my gut that the priest is writing them and for my benefit.
Damn it, priest.
From Helen Grant, the full report pending no immediate action is required on the part of the Murkoff Corp. The profit potential of Project Wallrider remains staggeringly high. The four fatalities contain enough ambiguous data to make any litigation of evidence is currently managed impossible. Project Wallrider remains a dangerous initiative, and there will almost certainly be further casualties. As with the others, however, family and government interest in the patients is so low as to make any chance of legal actions vanishingly unlikely. Violence among patients is increasing as morphogenic engine therapy gets closer to producing working models. But a combination of physical and chemical restraint is proven sufficiently effective to assure continued control and profit. Helen Grant.
I mean, look at that house. He's so fucked up, he's lighting up in the dark.
I know, I'm like, everything's black, but he's glowing.
Maybe it was just simple. No, Brian can wake back up in 3 days.
Photogenic dead body.
And you're also standing on here, which I don't
care. You can jump in this. Program CIA document number. Oh, they're talking about freaking Monarch programming. Okay.
aeronautic experimentation research. 1954, Wednesday, 10 October, blah, blah, blah. Nautical experimentation. Can't talk. Hypnotic experimentation and research work was continued in Building 13 of the Massive Reserve in Colorado using the following subjects. A freaking post-hypnotic of the night before point finger when you will sleep was enacted. What does it say? Mrs. Jackson appears immediately progressed to a hypnotic state with no further suggestion. Miss Pierce was the instructed, having previously expressed a fear of firearms in any fashion, that she would use every method at her disposal to wake Miss Jackson down in a deep hypnotic sleep, and failing this, she would pick up a nearby pistol and fire it at Miss Jackson. She was instructed that her rage would be so great that she would not hesitate to kill Jackson for failing to wake. Miss Pierce carried out these suggestions to the letter, including firing the unloaded pneumatic pistol gun at Jackson and then proceeding to fall into deep sleep. After proper suggestions were made, both were awakened and expressed complete amnesia for the entire sequence. Miss Pierce was again handed the gun, which she refused in an awkward state to pick up or accept from the operator. She expressed absolute denial that the foregoing sequence had happened. Yeah, it sounds a little bit like MK Ultra. Yeah. It's basically CIA experiments with LSD to forget for mind control.
Yep.
To actually research this stuff outside of a game.
Woo! Hey, you're right where you are.
Those noises. games.
Press start real quick.
Okay, you just press save next to it. You know it.
Thank you.
good.
His truth into the unbelievers. The only way out of this place is the truth. Accept the gospel, and all doors will open before you.
So it's not just a matter of random crazy people doing random crazy shit. It's something supernatural happening in this place.
Seems that way.
I think I accept it.
Alrighty, thanks guys. Bye.
Send us money.
Send us money.